Hello everybody, it's Coco, 27, I'm back. And today, I'm doing something a bit different. It's the Evolution Simulator by Minute Labs. Basically what it is you got little blobs like these, and it's just trying to, you're able to control different things. Happens with these blobs. Say how much food spawns in. Different traits of them. You can see their food. You can see there's different types of them. So there's 50 food. And on start. Yeah, so here we go. It was turned at generation 1. We're gonna find out what happens. So let's see what happens. Okay, so that was one generation. Remember, there was it started out with, I'd said two, there's four different ones, four blobs at the beginning with 50 food. No changes in amounts, but as you can see here, there's food left, and you see, by the end of each day, which shows the just the whole generation, just a generation at a time. And you see variations in them and evolving over time. Of natural selection at work. So some boost speed, some of the boost in energy, size and such. And what they have to do is go get food. If they pick up one food and make it back to their home, which is the outer area. Basically, in a day, and then, in this case, very fast, without me even noticing, they will just live another day, but if they don't, they die. And if they get two food before they make it back, they reproduce. So yeah. Let's go another one. Let us. Okay. Oops. Ugh, what's going on here? What the world has happened here? Not sure. Okay, so here they go. This is after one generation of. So I did a quick speed through of the first generation, just to skip, and mess some numbers up and variations a bit, but not too much. So now you can see that they're getting food. Some are getting multiple, and they're making their way slowly back to their homes. You see here, some of them died. Okay, they reset. Next day, they do it again, and so on. Speed is up. More dying, but let's just go a bit for a little while. See what happens. So there is. Let's see the trend. So view. Oh, so there's blue blobs and orange blobs. You can see by this graph. Population, 33, age, roughly. So 76 generations so far. Speed, size, and sense range. In other words, speed, obviously, how fast they can move, size, how large they are, which could dominate over other ones that are smaller, but it also requires more energy to survive. And its sense of range is, in other words, how far they're able to move, as well as how being able to find food, being to locate the food that's closest to them. So as you can see here, things are happening quite a bit. So I'm just gonna continue for a while longer. You can see here the numbers are hanging around, but you can see here the numbers are interesting. See here, they've seemed to even out. You see here, the numbers seem to be okay. You see all the spike from the beginning and all, but it wasn't too big. The birth and death, you can see here, net change, births and deaths. So yeah, you can see here there's some ups and downs. Not too bad though. It's fairly even for the most part. And food is a constant. Food available, 50. Food to eat in, 38. Per day is 38. And almost 100 generations. And creatures eaten, 1. That means a creature eating another creature, basically. And now it's 2 creatures. So that means that they're starting to eat each other, because the food supply is... Because basically, the food supply is still 50, but the amount of them are growing too much. Let's see here. Creatures eaten. Population, you can see here. You know, just until at the beginning here, had a normal spike, but now it's really, changing. So let's just see what happens. Let's just, continue. Just go a little bit quicker. Okay, GoGo27, remember to like, share, and subscribe, and turn on post notification bells, and if you miss another upload, out.